B-Monster Laboratory here. Today we're going to show you how to interface or set up or connect a water level detection sensor module to your Arduino. I'll be using Arduino Uno. When I first started posting videos on YouTube, they were from components that were in the Elegoo Mega 2560 starter kit, and this is one of those components. I never did get to it. It is a very simple component, but also a very practical component. Now this component does have a lot of uses. You could use it to measure rainfall or to indicate that it is raining. You could also use it as a water level indicator, which this summer, hopefully I'll post a hydroponics video, and we'll use one of these in that video, hopefully in July sometime. You could also use this to, say, detect a leak in an appliance, water heater, refrigerator, air conditioner, whatever, and very useful for that as well. There are many other uses, so I may post a couple of videos with this, so look for those. So with that said, let's go ahead and begin. So in this video, we'll be using three male to female jumper wires. We'll be using a couple of the male to male jumper wires, the water detection sensor, of course, and the Arduino Uno. I know this corresponds with lesson 18 of the Elegoo Mega 2560 kit, but we'll be using the Uno. You can also use the Nano or the Mega, whatever you want. And we'll be using a 5mm LED along with a 220 ohm resistor and a piezo buzzer and a breadboard. So here is the water level detection sensor, and you're going to find out with a lot of these sensors, they are dependent on resistance. This is no different. This has a 1 million ohm resistor, and it's got three pins here, as you can see. We'll talk about that in just a second. But you're going to notice these lines here. These are conducting lines, and or conducting wire. I believe they're copper. And when these lines are dry, the conductivity is going to be poor, and therefore you'll have a higher resistance. Now, when water is introduced, if water starts to build up, that conductivity becomes greater, and you'll get lower resistance. So as this is submerged and the water begins to rise, we can know the change of the water's depth through the analog to digital converter of your Arduino. And that takes me to the pins. Here are the three pins, and it's got a negative pin. It'll be connected to ground. The positive pin here, we're using Arduino, so it'll be connected to 5 volt, but you can also connect it to 3.3 volt. And then the S pin is our signal pin, and we will connect that to analog. Now it's time to connect this together, so we'll go ahead and do that. It's pretty simple. Got our signal pin. We'll just connect that to A0. We'll connect it just like it's shown in lesson 18 of the Elegoo Mega Kit. We'll connect the positive pin to 5 volt. We'll connect the ground pin to ground. Now we'll connect our piezo buzzer to pin 8. And then the ground pin of our piezo to ground. The positive pin of the LED is connected to a 220 ohm resistor. And the end of the 220 ohm resistor will be connected to pin 6. Just an arbitrary pin. And then we'll connect the ground pin to our final last remaining ground pin on the Arduino board. So it looks like that. Now as water moves up the sensor here, at first we'll see the LED light blink. Then once it gets to a certain point, we'll hear the piezo buzzer go off. I think that sounds like a pretty good alarm. So let's go ahead and set that up in the code. So this is the code, the sample code that they give you in the Elegoo Mega 2560 kit, the lesson 18. So we'll just start with that. And we see that they've already defined a couple of items for us up here, including the analog value, a history value, and a print buffer as well. We're going to add a couple things to it. We're going to start off by adding our piezo buzzer. So we'll call that integer, let's call it buzzpin, not bizpin. Buzzpin, and where do we have it? We had it on pin 8. And then we had an LED pin as well. So we'll call it LED or LED pin, keep it simple. And that is on pin 6. And then we'll come down here to setup. And we need to do pin mode, buzz pin. You know what I do a lot of the time is just cut and paste from top to bottom so I don't have to retype any typos. So let's just copy and paste this here. And you can straighten it out if you want. And then do LED pin. Because that's an output too. We're good with our setup. Now we'll come down to the loop. And we see there's an integer value that is equal to our analog reading. And if this condition is met, it will print it to our serial monitor, as you see here. But we're going to add a few things after that. Since we added a couple extra components that weren't mentioned in the code that was included in the Elegoo Mega kit, we're going to go ahead and add a couple if-else statements to power those components on and turn them off, the LED pin and the buzzer pin. Now remember, the value is going to increase as the water level increases. So we said if the value increases equal to or greater than 100, the LED light will come on. Otherwise, it's going to remain low or off. And if the value is greater than or equal to 600, that's maybe about halfway up the sensor, then our buzzer is going to come on. Otherwise, it will remain off. And down here at the bottom, I added a delay of 500 milliseconds or half a second. So let's see how this does. So now it's time to load it onto the board. Let's load it onto our Uno. This is why I usually type out the code ahead of time so I don't have problems like this. But I did capitalize the P in buzz pin, which I shouldn't have done. And I forgot a semicolon up there at the if value for the LED. All right, let's go ahead and load this onto the Uno. And it is loading. Let's open up our serial monitor up here, the top right. And I've got this little bowl. Let's put some water in it. Seems counterintuitive to do that around electronics, but I want to be careful. And you'll see the reading appear on the serial monitor as I'm adding water. And when it hits 100, the LED should come on. So I poured it a little bit fast, but there's 270. I'll pick it up a little bit. So it's at zero. So basically, there it is, 37. Okay, so the LED's on, it's at 200. I add a little bit more. Now it's at 424. Now we're almost at 500. There we go, 631. This is a sample code that came with the Elegoo kit, and the issue is the decreasing value as the sensor is just sitting in water. There we go. As long as it's over 600, the buzzer will go off. I believe the issue here is the continuous power provided to the sensor, which will shorten the lifespan of the sensor and cause heavy corrosion over a short period of time. I believe we can fix this by adding the positive pin of the sensor to a digital pin on the microcontroller and adding a delay right after the analog reading so that the sensor isn't continuously active. Let's go back to the code and add VCC pin to pin 4. In the setup, make the VCC pin an output. In the loop, we will turn the VCC pin on, take the reading, the analog pin, turn the VCC pin off, followed by a 1 second delay. Now we've dried the sensor off, and we'll stick it into a dry container. We'll add some water to it and see if the readings are a little more stable. I'm going to go back into the code and adjust these two values so that the buzzer doesn't go off so quickly after the LED does. And this is something you can play around with as you're doing your initial setup and adjustments. After we've added our 1 second delay to the code, we see that the value here is 437. It is doing an intermittent detection of water. And the value's not dropping, it's not bouncing all over the place. We'll slowly add water and see how those values react. So you can see after I added the delay, the values are not changing between adding water, and this is the way to do it. Only have your sensor on when it is measuring. And this will also keep your sensor from corroding too quickly. Well, that's all I've got for today. I do appreciate you watching. Thank you very much. If you did enjoy the video, be sure to like it by clicking the thumbs up. Share it with somebody who may find it interesting. And if you haven't done so yet, make sure you subscribe to the channel. And I'll see you again very soon.